Okay, welcome to another one of our effective community video tutorials. This one's the iMovie on the iPhone, and our task today will be to create a 45 second garden video. And today I'll be using the iPhone 6s Plus, which I'll be recording on and also editing on using the iPhone, the iMovie app, and I'll be using a 4K setting. So here we are, this is my mobile phone, and I'll just choose iMovie. Press the big plus, start a new movie, and here are some shots I took of the garden this morning. And we'll just select all those, and we'll create a movie. And there it is, 2 minutes 24 worth of clips. Now we've got to get that down to 45 seconds today. And I'm just scanning through here, just having a quick look at all the clips, and here they are. And the very last clip I took was here of the frog at the front door. Now, if I was a business community center, I might want to put my logo at the front of this. That might be in a picture. I don't have one of those, but I'm just showing you here that you could put a picture at the start of this, and that could be your title page. But in this instance, I'm going to use the frog as my title page for this video. And then it goes into the pomegranate flower. Now, each of these clips are roughly 15 to 20 seconds long. And the reason that they're that length is that there's always a bit of camera movement at the beginning and at the end of a clip, when you're touching the screen, turn it on and off. So the first thing I like to do is to go through and trim down all the little wobbles at the start and the beginning of each clip. So I've just done the pomegranate flower. Now I've got a wider shot here of just the garden in general. Oh, and the sprinkler coming on. So I'll just trim down the back end of the clip. And I'll trim up the front end, but I'm also having a look here at the start point. Some zucchinis have been repotted. There's a slight wobble start there, so I'll trim it back to that point. And what I'm doing is I'm touching the clip down in the bottom in the timeline. A yellow highlight frame appears, and then I'm dragging the ends towards the center. And as I'm scrubbing through the clip, I'm looking for wobbles in the picture. And then that's my mark to pull the end it back into. So here we have a shot of some eggplant. This is an 18 second clip. And then it pans down to a flower, but it looks like the flower is not in focus. So I might just take this one way back to the eggplant, I think. Here we go, just pulling it back. 2.5 seconds, that's fine. Here's a steady shot of a sort of zucchini plant. Okay, the wobble starts about there, so I'll bring it back to there. And there's a slight movement there, so I can bring that one back. And here we have some parsley that's gone to seed. A little bit of wobble there, and we'll just check the back end here, just pull it in a little bit. Another wider shot of the garden, looks a bit sparse from this angle. I might delete that one, okay, later on, we'll see. And here we have the last clip, which is actually the first clip that I took. And we're just dropping it in there. Shorten it up to 4.4 seconds. And there we go. Now, just to show you, what I've done here is I have detached the audio from the flower clip. And then I can stretch it out underneath the clip before it. And then what I've done here is I've split two clips. I've split the zucchini clip just to show you that you can do that. And then I've deleted the split off. So if you had a longer clip, you could split it down that way and then trim up all the little sections. Now in this one, I want to put a title here. So I've hit the T down the bottom in the left, which are for titles. And I'm going to choose a lower, just a basic lower third title here. So I delete out the words and type in what I want, which is greenhouse. And there we go. Now I can press the scissors again and I'll get back to your regular editing. There we go. Moving across now, I want a title on my title page. So again, highlight the clip, press T for titles, and you can just have a quick look to see which one do you think would be best here. Some of them are a bit more formal than others. This one might work, but I don't know. I think I want to add a little bit more information than just a single text box. There's the double text one. Let's just try this one with the three. Okay, so in the middle text area, I'm going to call it My Garden. And above that, I was going to write part one, but maybe I'll change that. So I'll delete that out and I'll just write where my garden is. So we're here in Gawler, South Australia. And then at the bottom, I think I'll put the date. Yeah, the date would be a better option. So November 2018. Okay, all done. That's looking pretty good. Now, if I want to change something, I could just go in there, I could select it all, select it out, no problems. Now the transition between my title page and my first shot, I don't want to dissolve, I want to fade. Yeah, to separate it from the rest of the video. All the others are little dissolves, which have been automatically put in there by iMovie, that's fine. And then at the end here, I want to fade out my movie as well to black. So to do that, I've got to go into settings, which is that cogwheel on the right. Alright, so I've highlighted the clip. I'll go to settings, and here we are. We have our options here, fade out to black and fade in from black. So fade in from black's for the start of the video, fade out to black's the end of the video, and while I'm here, I might as well add some theme music. So I'll turn that on. I'll choose bright will be fine, and I also have the ability to do some color grading for the entire video, every clip. So let's try a blast. It looks pretty punchy. Okay, so it just takes a little bit of time just for the phone to catch up processing that. And here we are. It's a bit more dreamy looking. Now I've stretched out this. So it's a little bit longer, so down to 3.4 seconds, just because of that extra fade that I've put on there. And here we are, we're just testing it now. And there we go, My Garden. Now, this title obviously is a bit too long, so I'm going to have to shorten this one down. I think that'll be my first thing that I do. And we've got our flowers. They're looking pretty good. The colour's good. The blues are blue and the green's green. Here's another one. I reckon there's a bit of a false start there on this sprinkler, so I'll be able to fine-tune that one up. So I'm making mental notes here. I'm going to watch it through, make some mental notes about what I like, what I don't like. Remember, I want to get this video down to about 45 seconds. So there's my greenhouse. That's looking all right. There's my lower third tidal. Everything's in focus. I'm looking at the steadiness of the shots. I'm looking at whether a shot is contributing to the overall video. There's our parsley seed. There's our last flowers, and there's our fade out. All right, let's go back to edit. Now the first thing I want to do is fix up those titles. They were just a bit too long here. So I highlight the clip, and I'll grab the end and I'll pull it in. I want to start about there nicely on the frog, and I want it to end, yeah, about there, the frog looking out over the pomegranates, I think. That's about 7 seconds now, that title. That should be long enough. And I'm just scrubbing back and forth. Oh, maybe we'll take another 3 seconds off it, down to 5 seconds. Okay. Now let's just play that. That feels about right. Okay. Pomegranates feel about right if I stop about now. Okay. So I'll pull the end in. Now I'm just doing this by feel now. How long should something last for? And I'm listening to the music while I'm doing this. I've got the music turned down at the moment because I'm talking over the top. But while you're editing, you'll be able to hear the music and you can put things in with the beat of the music. Now this was the sprinkler shot. There was a bit of a false start with the sprinkler. So I've located where the sprinkler, just before the sprinkler starts. Okay. So I'm just testing it here. Yes, the start of the video is, yep, the sprinkler comes on. And about there, I think that's enough sprinkler. So I'll come down, I'll pull that one back. To about there, that should be right. Yep. And I'm scrubbing back and forth and I'm looking in the main viewer. And we've got the shot of our 7 second shot of our zucchinis. It's probably way too long. So we can bring that one back to about 3 seconds. 3 seconds is usually about enough of a clip for most people. They get the idea of what they're seeing. So the sprinkler comes on, we go to the zucchinis, and then we've got the greenhouse. That pan movement might be a little bit too fast, but that's okay. Then we have our, yes, then we've got the eggplant shot, and then we've got the zucchinis. This eggplant shot, no, I don't like that one, so I'll just delete that out. So we'll go straight from the spinach seed to the zucchini, that's better. And then we've got this shot of the parsley seed, that's a nice shot. And then we come down to the flowers and we fade out. Now, look at that, 43.9 seconds, not too bad for our 45 second goal that we had. Okay, so at this point, we can export the video. I think I'm finished. So I'm just going to airdrop it to my computer as a video file. And there it goes. Now you notice there that you could also export it as an iMovie project, so you want to work on it on your laptop and further expand it. And if you did move it into your laptop, you could actually probably do, you can do it a little bit more with the iMovie app on the laptop compared to on a device such as an iPhone or an iPad. But in my case, I just want to export my movie back to my laptop. I can also from here WhatsApp it or Facebook it, or just store it on my phone. Okay, well at this point I was looking at it and I was thinking, oh geez, I could really do with an interview at the start. But I don't know, we'll have a look at what we've got so far. It's nice colours. Now I am shooting in 4K here. So There's my greenhouse. Loverford. Some spinach seed. There's my zucchinis. There's my parsley seed. And then there's my flowers. I'm thinking maybe I should include something of me talking at the start of the video. So I went away and I came back and I got a shot of me in the garden using the Rode SmartLAV.
Alright, we're rolling.
Okay, can you see the paper?
Yep.
Okay, you can't see the paper now? Alright. Hi there. My name's Andrew and this is my garden. Today's a nice bright sunny November day and I thought I'd take some shots of the garden just to share around with you.
Okay.
Here you go. We first started this garden 3 years ago and it was mainly rectangular beds. This year though, we decided to try something different and have gone with a circular maze design with more flowers. No, that's it. Okay, so that's the clip that I recorded after I'd watched my other clip. Now I want to drop that into my movie. So we'll go back into edit. And we'll scan along to the point. Now I want to have this after the froggy titles. So I'll just scan to this point here. That's good. I'll press the plus button over on the left under done. Oh, here we go. I'm just checking it here, I think. Yep, this is the point. Okay. Let's press plus. Comes up with video recently added. I'll choose that. And there's my 52 second clip. Obviously, this is going to blow out my 45 second video. Unless I do something a little bit tricky. You'll notice that half of it I did face to camera and half of it I read my script, and I think you're gonna get the idea of why I did that. Okay, now I was just a bit too blown out with the blast, so I can go through and individually just change the color grade on me. And Western, that looks pretty good. That looks not so bad. Okay, here we go. Now I'm just scrubbing through and I'm looking for the point where I start talking to camera. I think I'm just listening. I'm listening for my, I'm talking now. Okay, I'll go back a bit. And we're about here. Okay, and then I'll scan along. First thing I want to do now is I want to detach the audio from the video, and I'm going to let the audio run emerge underneath the other clips, and I'm going to pull back my video to hide the bit where I was reading off the piece of paper. Here we go. See that blue line starting to appear now under all the other clips? Here we go. Start pulling it back. Pulling it back. And it's just about over. That's a good shot, the finish one. Okay, now I want to do a bit of a fade here, so then it fades into the clips, just to separate me from the garden shots. Okay, so there I am, and you can see that blue line underneath, that's me still talking. Hi there, my name's Andrew, and this is my garden. Today's a nice, bright, sunny. Okay, now I want the talking to start a little bit earlier. just to keep the flow of the video going. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull that back, and you see the blue line starting to appear under the frog titles.
Hi there, my name's Andrew and this is my garden. Today's a nice bright sunny November day and I thought I'd take some shots of the garden.
Okay, that's not too bad. I'll just pull that audio back a bit. I don't think it worked too well, but there was a little bit of a sound there that I heard. There we go. And then I pull my clip back and see if I start a bit sooner now. Here we go.
Hi there. My name's Andrew and this is my garden. Today's a nice bright sunny November day and I thought I'd take some shots of the garden just to share around with you.
Now one thing I notice here is that the music might be a bit too loud compared to my audio.
We first started this garden 3 years ago and it was mainly rectangular beds. This year though, we decided to try something different and have gone with a circular maze design with more flowers.
Okay, yes. Now another thing that I noticed was that the music was a bit too loud. So I've just touched the music track and I'm pulling down, as you can see, 47-50% the music. There's the speaker and the slider. Okay, so that should bring down the sound of the music so you can hear me a little bit. Now on the end here, see the word fade over in the bottom right hand corner? I'm just shortening up the, remember that other piece of audio that we detached? That was just sticking out a bit, so I just put that one back. Okay, now I've got fade down in the corner there. When I press fade, it comes in with the fader cursor or triangle. So again, I'll highlight the thing and I press fade and there we go. Now if I press trim, then the big yellow bars come up and I can pull the ends in and out, or I can press or have the fader cursor. So there's two functions there that I can do, trim or fade. So I've just done a crossfade of the music, so the music fades out and fades in at the beginning of the video and fades out at the end. Okay, so let's just share that out now. Again, I can share it out as a video file, which I'm doing now. I'm going to export it out to my laptop. And remember what I said before, you could send it to WhatsApp and you could send it to Facebook. And in fact, I might do that as soon as this finishes exporting. I will just do a quick demonstration of sending it to Facebook. Now the longer your video, the longer it's going to take, so just make sure you have enough battery power while you're working on this, on a device. Okay, I've hit Facebook and it's come up with this. Now I'm already logged in. I'll just say a few things here. I press post and there it is. Here I am on Facebook, I go to my account and there's the video. Look at that. And I can play it. And I can make it a little bit bigger. And there we go.
Hi there. My name's Andrew and this is my garden. Today's a nice bright sunny November day and I thought I'd take some shots of the garden just to share around with you. We first started this garden 3 years ago and it was mainly rectangular beds. This year though, we decided to try something different and have gone with a circular maze design
with more flowers.